Assalamu alaikum, sabah al khair. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you, Hina, for the introduction and for the brief. And we do apologize for this delay because we receive many requests from people. They are coming on the way. So thanks for your patience and understanding. My name is Muhammad Alam. I'm the general manager of Qatar Detonation System. And I repeat again, it's a pleasure to have you all here, along with our key speakers who will be presenting their keynotes here. Just to visit again the agenda, you have it all with you about the topics that we will be covering in this event. QDS had established in 1983, and we do provide complete IT solutions. We act as a system integrator here in Qatar since that time. We do have the honor and the pleasure of serving all the segments and the customer in the state of Qatar. The areas that we cover goes from the computing side to the storage to the networking to security services, application, and enterprise solutions. This also represents the areas that we do cover. Major partners that we carry goes from the infrastructure, from the hardware, was it as data center infrastructure or the security partners that we do represent. Why? While we were preparing for this event and announcing it, we received a lot of questions of why. Why this event? Why we selected those topics? Why we have those gentlemen from three continents coming here, crossing all this distance to this event, and to mention and to talk about their expertise, being a subject matter expert on all those areas? And why questions. Reason behind this, that we had looked into the priorities and challenges of IT organizations in Qatar and in the region and worldwide. Where information technology has never had greater impact on business than it has today. Technology has become a defining factor of our business, our society, and our life. With billions of devices being connected via IoT, the Internet of Things, this means that the internet, that technology is not just around us, it's even will be one day inside us. Some of the challenges that we saw and we read, and it's mentioned and reported by CIOs, IT organizations, senior staff, talking about different areas. And the challenges have been getting a little bit different than what it was before, not about a decade back, but even a couple of years back. One of the challenges was leveraging data into actionable information, where IT organizations are not just expected to collect data. They are expected to collect the right data and to leverage them into actionable information. Other challenge was to maintain security. As we know, connectivity now becomes like an oxygen, and we need it to live. And this will open a lot of doors for cyber criminals and cyber attacks for people to start attacking us. Another challenge was driving agile innovation and being digitally innovative and not just doing digital. The transformation. As we all know, digital transformation is not about a change. Digital transformation is a journey of a transformation. Digital transformation major aspect is to create or improve the value proposition. And value proposition is linked to competitive advantage. Strategy creates competitive advantage. People and culture of innovation sustain this competitive advantage, and technology and communication is the means by which this competitive advantage and this value proposition is delivered. One special note had made by one group management expert saying that management is about doing things right, while leadership is about doing the right thing. Looking into this, this will create, the, let's say, the balancing act of IT organization on how to improve and how to create ongoing value by thinking strategically and acting digitally. It will be no wonder that one day we will see in organizations the title of CDO, the Chief Digital Officer, as they have now Chief Information Officer, Chief Information Security Officer, CTOs, COOs, and CEOs. This might happen, and we can't be surprised if this happened. With the evolution and revolution of technology, and the tectonic shift in the connectivity, and with the addition of the 5G, Internet of Things will be taking a lot of a huge space. When Internet was started, it was to connect people, to connect us with each other. And later on, now it starts to be Internet of Things, where everything will be connected. And soon, and it's very soon, it will be Internet of Everything. So having this connectivity, having multiple billions of devices connected via the Internet, and the connection happened, this opened a huge door for cyber criminals to start improving and increasing their dangerous and their sophisticated way of attacking our organizations, ourselves, and everything. It's estimated that in 2018, it has, as what has been published, that business has spent around $114 billion in cybersecurity to defend themselves, and it is expected in 2019 to be $124 billion. With another estimate that on average, every 39 seconds, there is an attempt from hackers to break into a computer. And also estimated that in 10 years from now, 80% of military budget, it will go to cybersecurity, to cloud, and to artificial intelligence. So, as they say, and as one of the Chinese proverbs saying that if you want to know what's in the future, look to your child. Because the things have been changing, and the future doesn't just happen as they say, the future gets happened, and we need to be prepared. So the future is not something far away from us. One day this will happen. Whatever we feel is a science fiction, it will become a reality, and we will have it in a view. Things will be talking to us, and even they will be talking to each other without us knowing or being there. And I think you can see it. The best chess that you play against, or count, or anything, is the computer. Artificial intelligence is being everywhere. At the end, and I don't want to take much time because I cannot be as good as the gentleman here to talk about all those topics, but one statement that we like much even, and as we started with why, we will end, and I will end with a why. As they say, if technology defines the how to change, then humans define the why to change. And I believe with all those things, with the changes happening in technology and in life, it's the time for us to stay human. So again, thank you so much, and I appreciate your presence here. And now we will start with our first session. And I would be welcoming Mr. Charles to talk about this. You have the bio about Charles and the experience and the books that have been. Yeah, and we would like to welcome.